Hello, everyone. Welcome to this homepage teardown. We're going to go through and dissect how Keap.com can improve their homepage conversion rate by at least 10% with some of the recommendations we're talking about. And here I have Pedro, who is leading an incredible program in February, where he's going to go through how to exactly do this for your own product. So we're going to give you a little bit of the behind the scenes of how Pedro thinks about SaaS homepages and what you can specifically do for yours to improve that overall conversion rate. So Pedro, what are some of the things that you think for Keap.com they are doing really well? And what are some other things and opportunities that they have to overall improve their homepage conversion rate?
There are a few things that they're doing well around the supports and around how they explain what kind of training that they can get and so on, which we'll show you later on. But actually, CRM and marketing automation is probably one of the most competitive markets out there between HR and a few other ones. And then it's very hard for them to stand out with a headline like this, right? One thing that they do well is that small businesses, because they do a lot of selling with calls, they're also comfortable being sold to in calls as well. So this is something that even if they don't call, they kind of trust it quite a lot. So that's something they're doing well. But like this headline, where small business growth happens, that's really not that great. What I would do instead is just say a place where you can manage all of your leads or something like that. And then right in here, all the different things that they do, right? So let's say we change this to one tool to, for example, manage your leads.
Yeah, or like automate
emails. Send emails, get calls. This headline is a little, the font size is a little bit too long, but too big, but that's more or less the idea, right? So manage your leads, send emails and create automations to reply to them, right? And then what we can say, all the things that they can do with it, right? So you can build automations that are gonna be like pre-built. You can manage all the leads from all the different sources, from phone calls and all these things, because they still get a lot of business through phone calls. To the reviews they have here, they should probably show the number. So let's say 150, and then for 4.6 on average, right? Something like that. And same thing here. Maybe it's 200 or whatever. So it would make it like way more quantifiable, way easier to understand that this might be something that can run the entire business and not be overwhelming. So that's something that I would improve in that sense. So other things that they do is that, they probably do some sort of segmentation here, which is okay. But the thing that they could improve a little bit better is they do show everything that they do. So they do the lead capturing, they do the automation parts, they do the email and text messaging. You can get your own personal number, but they didn't go deep enough, right? So for example, when it comes to lead capturing, where do these sources come from? So instead of having all these different people, why don't we have, I don't know, it came from someone that called me and found me on Google, and then someone else that found me on the website.
Or something.
Yeah, form. All these things go into one tool without them having to do anything, right? And then another big objection is, how do I migrate from one tool to another? We should be right here, because it's about the setup. This is literally the biggest objection that people have around CRMs, because switching from one to another is a complete nightmare.
Yeah. And I think one of the other opportunities you mentioned in a previous one too is like, what tools does this replace? So like, this replaces your lead capture tool. This replaces your like phone line. This replaces like a lot of those things, because I think when you just like immediately, if you go to the pricing page, you're like, it's more expensive like for a tool. But when you start to realize, you're like, I'm actually already paying $50 a month on this tool. I'm actually already paying like $50 like base on this other tool. They're like, this is cheap. And like, it's totally different. So
So the previous version of Basecamp, they had like a dropdown where it would compare five users for Google Drive and five users with Asana, five users with something else. And it would be obvious that would pay way more. So that's something that they could do here as well. Because obviously they charge more than what a typical CRM would charge for this amount of contacts, and they need to explain the value better so people still think it's a good deal, right? So that's one thing. When it comes to automations, right? What does this mean? It don't show me doesn't show me that I can easily build the automations, because here, small businesses, they're really tech adverse. They're kind of afraid of tech, pretty much, right? So they're afraid they're not going to be able to set this up. They're afraid that they might set it up wrong, or they don't even want to set it up in the first place. So a good way of showing this is just maybe a video of building one automation and kind of showing what's possible. So for example, if a lead comes to their website, it gets an email saying that they're going to get a callback or whatever. It depends on the business. And what would be way more irresistible than that is showing that you have 30 plus automations already pre-built. Mm-hmm. That you can just choose whatever one you want to use. Right? So all these things that they're missing out on that we're not really explaining, we're not going deep enough. For example, messages and text marketing. What I mean by this is if you use emails and you use text messages, you're probably going to get twice the leads to actually read it, right? So you're not selling me on texting, you're selling me on twice as many people reading it and actually the tool doing it for me without me having to do anything, right? So they're missing the point. This one is okay. They say it's a business line, so it's more or less clear. And it is something that people want, right? So they want to separate this from business. The only thing that they should probably talk about is if they can set specific hours where the phone doesn't ring or something like that, right? So that's what they need to be doing better. The two things that they did really well are these results here. So our business double in just 1 month with Keap. That one actually sounds unrealistic. If we said our leads doubled in 2 weeks or all the response rates doubled in 1 month or whatever, that would sound more realistic. They do have a video here, which is perfect. It doesn't have to be highly produced. It's even more trustworthy that way. And the expert help is really good because they not only they show you that you get 24/7 supports, but you get a support from an expert, right? That's going to help you migrate and help you learn the tool. And if you position it that way, that is worth the extra price because you get proper supports on how to use it, right? The rest is it's like okay at best.
Okay. So let's play out a scenario here. Keap.com hires you. And you have less than, let's say, a month to improve their homepage conversion rate by 10%. What are the first few things you're going to be doing to immediately improve this?
Yeah, I think we can probably get a little bit more than 10% here. What I would do thing here is like the things that I've like been showing you here before, like one tool for all your leads, right? So one tool where you can message leads, you can call them, you can send emails and all these things. So it automatically comes in with that idea that they're going to replace a bunch of tools. Then I would go deeper on every single one of these, right? So showing how easy it is to migrate, where are the leads coming from, that all of these things are seamless. There's no copy and pasting. There's no importing from CSVs twice a week, right? None of that. Same thing with the automations, that there are all automations are already pre-built and a few ideas on like what actual use cases you can do with all of these automations. Same thing here. Like I'm not interested in messages. I'm interested in getting twice as many people to read my marketing messages, either email or text. All right, so I would go deeper on all these things. Actually, the order is really good. So I think if we tweak that, that would be great. But I actually go as far as also tweaking the pricing and show that they're saving a lot of money as well. So I'm going to give you an example from a client in the past. I think maybe it's co.uk. Don't remember. It's like, it's like get FLG. So is this one here. And in their pricing, they show that they replace, like they have all of these things from just £80 a month for 5 users. And then it's clear that is a little bit more value, right? I would go as far as having a table here on the side saying all the tools that you would replace. So you would replace a tool to call people. You would replace a tool to maybe get leads from your website, an email marketing tool, right? Replace all that stuff. And then plus the support, because the support is huge, because it looks like their support is really good, right? Because other companies kind of have partners that charge a lot of money. And that alone is probably worth the premium that they're charging for. And that would actually help justify how much they're charging and making it seem like they're perfect for SMBs. Something that they're going to have to set up once. Something they're going to get a lot of results for. And something that is going to be like super easy for them to use. Right? Because they're very tech adverse.
Yeah, I think the combination that Keap has too is really, really cool. Like to have everything in all in one place. And that's huge advantage, but I think they're really underplaying like the value of all of this because you like as an entrepreneur, you add a lot of tools over time and then you're like, actually, I'm already paying a lot. I'm for, like, you might look at it as like adding another tool. Oh man, like I don't want to spend another $200 per month on another tool, but if I could eliminate like 10 of them or like five of them, like that would already be saving me. Like what are the savings here? And I think we're like changing the equation of like, this is actually not more, it's less. And getting people in that context is huge.
Yeah, because then it's the offer is completely different, right? So you can get everything in one place. There's no more copy and pasting. You can probably get twice as many replies. You set it up the automations once and you have them run forever. The migration is pretty easy and they're going to help you with that. And the support is much better. And so if we can get the angle that they can also save money by replacing like five different tools, you cannot really refuse that.
Yeah. And I think the other like unheard part of this story of a small business owner is like really play into you. You're not supposed to be the orchestrator. Like you're just like, everything's one place. So you can focus on doing your business and not worrying about like all the tooling and everything else too, which is big. So overall, like recap, like 1 to 10, 1 being this is like absolutely terrible kind of homepage, to 10 being like, this is world-class. Like I would not touch or change anything else. Where do you feel like keap.com stands right now?
I think it's definitely around a 5 because there's so many ways that it can be improved. And small businesses are actually a very skeptical audience. They're very tech adverse. They probably had really bad experiences with SaaS companies in the past. So imagine how many things you have to address for them to feel like this is so much better to a point where it's worth switching from one tool to another and overcoming that resistance and all those fears.
Totally. And so what's the like top one recommendation you would say, if you're just going to do one thing, listen to one thing, what would that be for them to implement?
It would be the hero in showing how many tools they can replace and that they're going to have all the leads in one place and that they set it up once and forget about it. And they're probably going to help with the setup as well. Because these things, they could be definitely better. But like worst case scenario, they can click on the page and a little bit more and so on. Right. So that's going to be the biggest problem. But like I mentioned, man, if I have a month, I have plenty of time to like literally start from scratch and redoing the whole thing. Right. So it's plenty of time there.
Awesome. Well, everyone, thanks so much for listening for this homepage teardown at keap.com. We're curious to hear what you think. Let us know what you like about keap.com's homepage. What are some things you think they could improve as well? And overall, what you thought of this specific teardown?